There has been a lot of talk, and I mean a lot of talk, about Modern Warfare ever since we saw the official multiplayer reveal a little while back. And while there has been some concerns here and there about certain things in the game, there has also been a lot of hype as well. And in the recent days since the reveal took place, some Infinity Ward employees have took to social media to spill the beans on even more content and features that'll be coming with Modern Warfare, and pretty much all of it is very, very exciting. We've got some new intel on killstreaks in the game, and how you'll actually be able to adjust them in some pretty fun ways, alongside the confirmation that post-launch content will not be exclusive to multiplayer. And we've even got some brand new teasers and very cryptic hints about the potential of a Battle Royale mode being included in the game, either at launch or shortly thereafter. So today we're taking a look at the latest Modern Warfare news and intel, and I am kind of curious, would you guys like to see this as a little weekly thing? Like maybe once a week on every Friday or something, we do a Modern Warfare weekly recap and talk about all of the latest news and other info that's come out. We're gonna see a ton of stuff come out in the next few days and weeks leading up to the beta, so feel free to let me know what you think about that down below. Anyways, before we do get into everything for today, if you are new here and you want to stay up to date with everything going on in the world of Call of Duty, be sure to subscribe with your post notifications turned on, and of course if you do enjoy the video, let me know by dropping a like rating on it, as it would be much appreciated. And now let's get into all of the newest intel for Call of Duty Modern Warfare. So we've got all sorts of stuff to talk about today, and I just want to let you guys know that all of this info is coming straight from Charlie Intel, so you can find that site linked down below. And for starters today, the first topic of discussion relates to the dreaded loot boxes.
No! God, please, no! No!
So while this does not directly relate to Modern Warfare in specific, Modern Warfare should technically be affected by it, and that is the fact that soon, Sony, Nintendo, and Microsoft will require publishers on their platform to disclose the odds of earning items in loot boxes. And seeing as Activision obviously publishes Call of Duty on PlayStation and Xbox, that means if there were to be loot boxes in Modern Warfare, once this rule goes into effect, we would have to be able to see the odds and rarity chances of the items that are attainable. Which, while it might not sound like the biggest leap forward, ridiculously bad odds like the 0.1% chance you have of earning weapons in Black Ops 4 might not be that bad if the public can actually see said odds. Another thing that was just confirmed for Modern Warfare this week is that the game will be running on dedicated servers all across the board for Xbox One, PlayStation, PC, and cross-play lobbies. Now, dedicated servers are not necessarily brand new, but with the addition of crossplay, having stable connections is going to be pretty important to say the least. Then another pretty significant detail that was teased this week is that of campaign gameplay coming soon. When asked over on Twitter, Taylor Kurosaki, the studio narrative director for Infinity Ward, said that gameplay would be coming soon, and that within the campaign, we'd see the return of other familiar faces, like perhaps Ghost, Gaz, Soap, and or Roach. Once again, Taylor was not super specific here, but it is a confirmation at the very least. And coinciding with all of this new campaign info, specifically the idea that we'll be seeing some gameplay soon, is the announcement that Activision is going to be a part of the opening night stream for Gamescom on August 19th, where perhaps we'll be able to see some secret stuff revealed during their on-stream time, like for instance, maybe that new campaign gameplay, since August 19th is pretty soon, all things considered. Now though is where we really get into the very interesting stuff for today, as these next new confirmations and info drops are all pretty big when it comes to the core gameplay within Modern Warfare. We actually found out just a couple of days ago that Modern Warfare is going to have a perk that will allow you to change your killstreaks into score streaks, and there will also be a perk that will change your killstreaks into specialist streaks as well. If you guys remember back in Modern Warfare 3, and also Ghosts I believe too, we had these specialist streaks which allow you to essentially become a super soldier as you build your gun streak up, as you acquire more and more perks as your streak progresses. And then at a certain gun streak, you'll actually end up unlocking the specialist bonus, which gives you quite a few other perks as well. But Joe Seacott did explain that your specialist bonus in Modern Warfare will not grant you access to all the perks, but instead a good amount of them. So personally, I am very, very excited about that. I was a big specialist user back in MW3 and even Ghost for that matter, and I loved it, so I am very excited to see the system return here in MW. We then also have score streaks returning, as I just mentioned, which can be activated by using the perk called Point Man. Moving on from that though, as I detailed in the intro to the video, we also have yet another very cryptic response from Infinity Ward regarding the ever so elusive Battle Royale mode that some people desperately want to see included in the game, and others desperately don't. Nonetheless, in a rapid-fire interview with Game Informer, Joel Emsley, the studio art director for Infinity Ward, was asked if they have any plans to include a Battle Royale mode in the game, to which Joel responded with, "We'll have to wait and see." Now, previously it was announced that when asked about a Battle Royale mode, a different Infinity Ward employee said that they were just focused on multiplayer for the time being. And this actually kind of lines up with a theory that has been going around for quite some time now, and that is the idea that Infinity Ward is not making a Battle Royale mode, but instead, Beenox, High Moon, and or Raven are working on that and leaving the rest of the game to Infinity Ward. And we're not sure if there is any validity behind that statement, but just connecting the dots, seeing as it was said that Infinity Ward is focusing on just multiplayer as of now, and without a direct denial of a BR mode being in the game, I'd say the whole Raven-led Battle Royale mode is certainly possible at this point. Once again, going back to that Gamescom appearance though, perhaps we could get some form of Battle Royale intel there, but I guess we are just going to have to wait and see. Also, a little post-edit here as I was recording this, Charlie Intel actually released a brand new article saying that there are now rumors going around saying Battle Royale will be coming to Modern Warfare in early 2020 as a major post-launch DLC update, which honestly I think would be the best way to go about it, as an update like that would be huge to see post-launch. I'm sure by now all of you guys know about the quote-unquote Call of Duty cycle, where the new game comes out, we all think it's amazing, and then it starts to get a little bit dry and stale, and then we all look back on the older Call of Duty and say, man, that Call of Duty was great. So, what if around that time when the new Call of Duty, Modern Warfare in this case, is starting to become a little bit dry and stale, Infinity Ward goes and drops the Battle Royale mode? That is going to completely decimate the Call of Duty cycle and completely reset it, and I think that would be absolutely awesome to see. Yet another thing we did end up discovering this week is that the Spec Ops mode for Modern Warfare is going to be much more in-depth than in the past, as well as it's going to be a continuation of the game's campaign. But to top it all off, Joel Emsley also revealed that there will be post-launch support for Spec Ops, and seeing as it is a part of the campaign in a sense, this means we'll actually be seeing some form of campaign-based DLC come to the game later on down the road, which is pretty exciting if you ask me. We'd never really see any kind of campaign DLC in Call of Duty, so this would be the first time to see that happen, and I for one am pretty interested in that. Then, to wrap things up for today, we've also got a few smaller pieces of information that were released this week, including that the Ground War map that is set for the 64 plus player version of the mode is going to be set in a huge map that includes vehicles. It was said via a Game Informer post that the map features a lot of open space, high sightlines from key landmarks, and areas with sparse cover, and it is apparently taking place in the downtown of a city where you can use vehicles, choppers, and other forms of transportation to navigate the map. So really, what I'm getting out of this is the fact that Call of Duty is doing Battlefield better than Battlefield. I might have just angered some people with that statement. Please keep your tomatoes at bay. I'm just kidding. Kind of, but seriously, it is cool to see that Call of Duty is taking a very different approach to its traditional multiplayer experience with the Ground War mode this year. And speaking of something very different, Tamagotchis are going to be in Modern Warfare as a brand new accessory called Tamagunchies, and this will be a little watch-like arm accessory that displays a little digital pet that will react to your gameplay. If you're doing well, the pet is going to be happy. If you're playing like a Timmy, the pet is going to be sad. So now, if you're going 3-28, not only are you letting your team down, but you're also letting your Tamagotchi down as well, and no one wants to feel that guilt. So if you don't want to let your Tamagotchi down, use code IMMORTAL on some G Fuel. You'll be more energized and be able to focus more on dropping nukes rather than going negative, if you catch my drift. With all of that being said though, that is effectively everything we learned about Modern Warfare this week, and that is going to wrap things up for today. As I mentioned in the intro, if you guys want to see this become kind of a weekly or even bi-weekly thing, as more Modern Warfare intel becomes available, let me know down in the comments below. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to drop a like rating on it, as it would be much appreciated. And of course, if you are brand new here to the channel and you want to stay up to date with everything going on in the world of Call of Duty, feel free to subscribe with your post notifications turned on. That way you'll always know when a new video goes live. Once again, thanks so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.